I'm here with Dr. Scott Plotkin from the Massachusetts General Hospital. Dr. Plotkin, you've been spending the majority of your work in the NF2 and schwannomatosis fields. Could you discuss a little bit about the Avastin trial or bevacizumab that you've been working on, and kind of what patients can do in their own areas of the country?
So where we are right now is that we're in the process of updating our initial results that we reported previously, trying to understand in a larger group of patients whether those initial observations, in fact, were accurate. And now we've reviewed the records of 31 patients who've been treated off-label. And in general, we find very similar results to what we reported initially. That is, about half or slightly more of patients do see an improvement in hearing. And about that same number sees a significant shrinkage in their tumor size. This has led us to design and begin a clinical trial now, which is a more controlled study of whether bevacizumab is helpful for patients with NF2 and progressive vestibular schwannomas. This clinical trial is really the gold standard, more so than the initial studies we've done. The trial is being led by Dr. Jayashree Blakely at Johns Hopkins. Mass General Hospital and the National Cancer Institute are participating. And enrollment has been very good, that patients are getting on study. And so we do hope that this will help us know a lot more about the activity of the drug. We do hope to have more trials of bevacizumab for patients with NF2, because there's many questions to be studied. And I hope that we'll be participating with the Department of Defense Consortium that's very interested in doing this. I think for what people can do is, unfortunately, being patient is still going to be part of what we have to do, because my worry is that some patients will want to be treated with bevacizumab really in a setting where they may not need it. For example, if the tumors aren't growing or if they don't have hearing loss. It is a drug with side effects, and we have to be respectful of that fact, and we don't want to treat patients before they need it. And I think the next few years are going to be really wonderful years for us to learn how active this drug is, and hopefully we're going to have something that'll help a lot of people. But we don't want to go in and end up hurting somebody.
Absolutely. Would you say, clearly if I'm an NF2 patient, I've got tumors, I want this fixed today. I want this fixed now. I mean, is it safe to say that Avastin will work on every tumor that's ever, been present on anybody?
Good, great question. So the answer is no, unfortunately. We wish that we found a medicine that was going to help every tumor. And I think that's the important question is, what does it treat, and are you somebody in that setting? So for me, what I tell my patients is, let's have you learn about your own tumors and follow them. We need to empower patients to know what's going on in their body. Right now, we think that bevacizumab is active for patients who have growing vestibular schwannomas with hearing loss. That's a very restricted group of patients. For patients with spinal tumors or meningiomas, our initial data suggests that only a percentage respond to bevacizumab. So we're going to learn more about those tumors, and there may be a clearly defined group that will benefit. But right now, for my patients with meningiomas, I don't advise them to take bevacizumab until we know more about it.
Yeah. So, right now it's a good option for certain specific patients, and we're working to find more.
Absolutely, and I think it's fair to say that this is our number one priority among all of the clinical researchers who have patients we're trying to help. It's always slower than we like, both for the doctors and for the patients. And the important thing is, you have to do these studies safely to protect patients, but also if you do have bad outcomes for certain patients who maybe shouldn't be on the trial, it can also stop a drug from being approved by the Food and Drug Administration. So we want to be very careful, because our end game is to get this approved for patients so they don't have to be on research studies to get it. And I think we're making really fast strides.
Well, Dr. Plotkin, thank you very much for your hard work in all these areas, and we will do our best to get the word out there.
Sounds good. Thank you so much.